Hey everyone, Tim from Fit for an Autopsy here to talk about the riffs that taught me. The two songs that I chose were definitely pinnacle when it came to me learning guitar and learning techniques or scales or picking techniques, so on and so forth. And that's why I chose them, because I felt like they were songs that could help other people. So without any further ado, here they are. So the first one is Lamb of God's Laid to Rest off of their record Ashes of the Wake. It's the first song off the record, and I had heard them before tons of times, but this was definitely one of those riffs for me that helped me make sure that my alternate picking technique in my right hand was just absolutely flawless. Even still playing this nowadays, I credit that riff and probably about four or five others for making my right hand so on point and so in time. Second up is one of my favorite band, Opeth, one of their riffs off of Blackwater Park, the song called Bleak. I was 12 years old when it came out, and you know, being that young and only listening to Metallica and Slayer and Pantera and you know, your starter pack metal bands, this was definitely one of those records that just completely blew me out of the water, out of the black water. Now, this was one of the riffs that really broke me into learning different scales. Hearing a harmonic minor scale like this and hearing how they changed from scale to scale within the same riff, for me, just completely blew my mind. Because at the time, the way I had learned, you know, you were only playing one scale in one riff. Like, you weren't interchanging scales within the same riff. Like, that was crazy to me. It was definitely one of the riffs that definitely made me, and made me into who I am as a guitar player today. So I'm happy that I could share these two riffs. One, obviously, the Laid to Rest riff being a little bit more popular and a little bit more well known. But hopefully I can open that door for guitarists or you know, players that don't really know about a band like Opeth. Even though they're widely known, you know, you might not know any of those riffs. So definitely check them out. Big ups to them for making me who I am today.
1993, Carcass released the record Heartwork, and on that record there was a song called Embodiment that was a culmination of all the things that I liked. Super, super heavy, cool bouncy riffs. It's just, it was evil sounding and really cool. And there's a section in there that's just little bouncy kind of section that just moves around the 12th fret a little bit, and it was pretty approachable and kind of an easier one for me to learn, and I just grabbed it and went with it. So this is a section from the song Embodiment by Carcass. Note that this guitar is an E standard, but that recording is done in B standard, so it will sound a little different, but the notes are correct. In 1986, Metallica released Master of Puppets, and on that record there's a song called Damage Incorporated. It's got this section in it where it's like a pretty crazy flurry of, you know, picking, where they're mixing different styles of picking, some down picking, some alternate picking, just like a definitely an interesting section. And at that time, it was different than a lot of other things that I had ever heard. And it's one of my favorite sections by Metallica. So here is a section from Damage Incorporated by Metallica from the record Master Puppets. So in 1988, Metallica released the record A Justice for All, and on that record there was a song called Dyer's Eve. It's super fast, crazy amount of picking combinations between like alternate picking and stops and starts and, you know, down picking, and just like the Metallica thing at this era was pretty impressive. And the song's super fast, it's fun to play. So here is a section from the song Dyer's Eve by Metallica off of the And Justice for All record.
What's up, guys? My name is Peter Spinazzola. My friends call me Blue. I play bass in Fit for an Autopsy, and I'm here to show you guys some of the riffs that taught me. So I started playing guitar originally when I was probably around 12 or 13. I picked up bass a couple years after that in my mid-teens. And what really has always driven me as far as, you know, getting my playing up to par, guitar and bass, is just kind of the power of the almighty riff. Whether it be, you know, that kind of thing that just makes you lose your mind or headbang real hard. It's always been about riffs for me. You know, I'm a rhythm-driven player, and that's just what's always grabbed me. You know, picking apart those rhythm riffs, whether it be guitar or bass, really helped me kind of figure out what I needed to work on and really hone my chops to make sure I was able to, you know, keep up pace with, you know, other people over the years. But, you know, enough about me. Let's get on to the riffs. Iron Maiden, Wrathchild, probably one of the earliest introductions that I had to, you know, proper hard rock, heavy metal fingerstyle technique. The three-finger technique, as some of you bass players might know it as, you know, something popularized by Alex Webster, but introduced to me by Steve Harris from Iron Maiden, not personally, through record. But regardless, it kind of got me established on the 3-2-1. Taught me how to do that kind of constant rotation of the 3-2-1, 3-2-1, 3-2-1, and kind of get me grounded and kind of learn, you know, the proper mechanics of getting my fingerstyle technique down. Definitely a big one for me early on when I was a kid. Metallica, My Friend of Misery, along with, you know, your Iron Maiden, Judas Priest, you know, all of your heavy metal, the classic period, and like, Metallica was huge for me in getting into metal, and huge in bass playing in metal. Jason Newsted, the then bass player of Metallica, kind of was a big influence for me as far as a pick style bassist is concerned, and a song like My Friend of Misery kind of let me know that bass can be a carrying instrument as far as delivering a riff and kind of pushing the song along. And along with that, it was also a huge proponent in allowing me to apply alternate picking to my bass playing, whereas Maiden was kind of helping me with my finger style. A lot of Jason's Metallica era stuff kind of got me with more proficient with my pick attack and stuff like this. Kind of learn to apply what I was getting down on guitar into the bass contact and kind of transfer that rock solid rhythm technique, like rhythm picking, over to bass and really kind of get me harder locked into the groove on it. So there you have it. There's a couple of the riffs that taught me, showed me how to be a better bass player when I was starting out. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I'll see you out there, and remember, stay metal.